Hello everyone, thank you for clicking on this video and welcome to the first video on the Viva Lina YouTube channel. I will bring to you creative gaming content, for now mostly Planet Zoo, but I am open to also explore other games here. So the reason for me to start this channel is that I have been watching a lot of YouTube content of other Planet Zoo builders and I have gotten a lot of inspiration from them. And I thought it would be cool if I can also share some of the things I do and maybe I can inspire one or two people out there. That would already make me super happy. So we are starting with this Halloween project. It is the Abandoned Graveyard Zoo. So as the title says, this is an abandoned graveyard, but it is actually not really a zoo. Of course, we will later have people coming there and visiting, but the general historic idea of it is, if you think about how this whole place came to be, it's not a graveyard that got repurposed to be a zoo. It is a graveyard that really got abandoned by the people and they stopped going there. And when they started to come back, people have been reporting strange noises going on, red lights flickering in the night from the church, and dangerous animals crawling around the area, so even less people have been going there. So it has only been recently that people have started to explore these grounds, to go there at their own risk against all logic, and to see what dangers it has to bring. Because this is not a maintained zoo, which also means that nobody really takes care of the safety of the visitors. And yes, of course, we will have keepers feeding the animal, but the story idea, these would not exist. The animals somehow find food themselves, maybe the witches come by and feed them, but it's not a touristic attraction as a zoo. And this also brings me to the other aspect. This is not meant to be a realistic zoo, by no means. It's a heavily themed project which just wants to bring some creativity, some way to otherwise think about the game than you usually would do, and maybe just go a bit crazy, go a bit dark, and just really celebrate Halloween and celebrate the amazing options we have in this game to also build on something completely else. So this is a YouTube project which will be split into two parts. The first video is the one you are seeing right now, and the second video will be published tomorrow on October 31st, and it is actually just a two-part series. So tomorrow you will get to see the final result and of course some live footage where we just get to take in the beauty of the game and the spookiness of this abandoned graveyard. We are starting with the crocodile swamp, the one that has already been being built here in the background. So this is meant to be an area which is maybe one of the oldest areas of this graveyard, and it has also suffered most under all the bad weather conditions, all the rain and snow and so on, which is why it has gotten like this little swamp there. And I really wanted to make it look shallow. This is why we have all these plants being put there to really stick out and seem like there's just some water there. But the crocodiles, they are still able and happy to swim in it, so they are happy about it and so am I. And as you see, these crocodiles do not have any fence. There used to be one, but I decided to take out that footage because it was not gonna stay in there. And this is because, I mean, it is creepy to have crocodiles on a graveyard, but if they are fenced in, that's alright. But now imagine going to a graveyard and there is no actual fence to the crocodiles. That would be really creepy. And I said, it's a Halloween zoo, so it's meant to be spooky. And thanks to sandbox options, still crocodiles still will not attack the humans, which I am quite happy about. And yeah, all the zoo, of course, will have these amazing mist effects just because I really like them in the game and I rarely get to use them because it rarely makes real sense for me. And here it was just the occasion, and of course also to play with the lights of it, because the zoo is meant to be visited on daytime so you can see the detailing and so on, but it is also meant to have this very nice vibe if you turn it to night mode. And I think one of the most beautiful times in Planet Zoo in that area is around 8 or 9 p.m. according to Planet Zoo time, because it just has this great dark light, but not yet pitch black. And yeah, here you see me at the attempt of building a realistical skeleton. I have to say, it does not quite look how I imagined it. Maybe I just need some more practice in skeleton building. But I have to say, these African stones that I use there, they are quite nice for it. They also have the right color, even though I wish they were a bit recolorable. But yeah, here you see me building this, and I actually modeled it after a picture I saw. And at some point I decided that I will not be building the whole skeleton. I will stop midway, you will see this in a second, and just sink it into the water. So that still works. But I have to say here, like, I love to see what people put in the workshop. And I always was impressed with those skeletons that are there. And now, after trying one myself, I am even more impressed, because this is not that easy of an undertaking, and it's also hard to make it like recognizable. But yeah, here you see me just sinking that skeleton boy into the water and just giving it this little spooky extra there, even seeing the head, the ugly skeleton head. And now we come to the second part of the speed build, which is the wolf church, the one you maybe already saw in the thumbnail. So the whole point of a graveyard is that you also have to have a church, of course. I don't think I have seen a graveyard which does not at least have a church close by, and I already have mentioned this church before. So this is where I'm building it. It's quite simple, because on graveyards you would not usually find the most extravagant churches, but more something simple which serves the purpose. And that's also what we will have here. I have not built any interior for the church, and I will also keep it that way. Guests will not actually be able to enter it, but somebody else will. And yeah, that's what I'm building here. And a bit later on, the church will also shrink in its size. So I made it a little bit smaller, just because it seemed, after all, still a bit too massive. And there I could use these doors, which normally I never do, so I was quite happy to find out that even the outer part is also recolorable. And I mean, these parts are not, but yeah, here you see just this putting in the church. And funny story to that is, in the part behind the church, I started building this very structured graveyard, took a lot of work. I even did some terraforming, painting paths in there and so on. And then I realized that if I want my haunted forest, it has to be at the front of the church. But it didn't make sense in the overall setup of the zoo, because it would be opposite to the whole crocodile thing. So that's something you will not see in the video. So now you will see it in one way, but later on in the same videos it will be turned around. Maybe take a look, see if you can spot the difference, because I had to change it all around, and I did that off camera just because it is not that interesting, and it was maybe also a bit painful for me to do so. So yeah, that part is not in here. And then here again, I think this is the point in time to remind you, it's a theme project, it's a Halloween zoo. I don't actually know that much about Satanism, but I still wanted to have this cool, nice, spooky star, which it is for me, because I just thought that's like the biggest contract to the church that I can build there, and which will go on there. And it actually looks quite cool, because this is built out of those lamps, you know, and the ones that glow, so we'll have this amazing cool glow and also give it this less touch of realism, let's say, and a bit more fantasy. And yeah, there I'm continuing to decorate the church. You will see me build the little graveyard, use the crosses I have built before. They will also be used all over the zoo again and again. And one more thing which is happening here is, the church is on a slight hill, but with the time there also has been a hole dug under it, and now the wolves can go inside the church. Originally I wanted to go them to go on the floor level of the church, but that didn't quite work out with their traversable area, so in the end they just have a nice cave under the church. And they really love their cave. So whenever I wonder where all my wolves are, I just need to check under the church, and they are all there cuddling, being happy, being a nice cuddly wolf pack under the church collected. And this here might be the darkest part of the whole graveyard project, because this is, as you maybe already figured out, gonna be a coffin. And we're gonna have some open coffins lying around here. And maybe I even went so far as to put one of the feeders in there. And this is really, it's a fun project. It's not meant to mean anything. And I just thought this would be something that happens in Halloween. We are all happy to eat like sausages with almonds in it and call them fingers. So I thought, ah, it's okay if the wolves eat out of the coffin as well. And yeah, that's what we are having here, and soon also the graveyard being structured. In a second, I will leave you alone to just enjoy the speed build and a bit of the music I put there. And I just wanted to let you know that this is the last habit hut that I will be building in the speed build. But at the end, there's still a cool little surprise. So if you watch to the end, why don't you put down a comment about what the last thing is that I'm building in this part one of the speed build. And then otherwise, remember to come back tomorrow to watch part two of this Halloween special. And I would be happy and thankful for any comment where you let me know what I could do better, what you really like, what you want to see more of, also in the sense of Planet Zoo content. I will most likely be working on rather small projects, so it's also easier to see them come to and finish. Mostly because also my computer will not be able to handle those huge zoos that you build over the years. But also because I just think it's really nice when you watch and you can see something from start to the end without like months in there that it takes. Even though I have to say those things impress me a lot. But I will concentrate more on the smaller projects. And yeah, of course, even though this is the first video on a new channel, it would mean a lot to me, even more if you left the subscription, if you hit the subscribe button, and I will bring more Planet Zoo content to you. So have a lovely day, enjoy your weekend, and I hope to see you soon.